Listening Library presents Katie Kazoo Switcheroo, Book 4, Girls Don't Have Cooties, by Nancy Krulik. Read by Ann Bobby.
Girls Don't Have Cooties. Chapter 1. Here comes Jeremy, Suzanne Locke said. She looked out across the school playground. She quickly handed her best friend Katie Carew an envelope. Put this in your backpack, fast. Katie looked at the envelope curiously. What's the big secret? She asked. It's an invitation to a party this Saturday at my house, Suzanne quickly explained. Oh, Katie answered. So why do I have to hide it from Jeremy? Just give him his invitation too. Suzanne shook her head. Jeremy's not invited. No boys are. It's just for the girls in our class. Katie was shocked. You mean you're only asking half of our friends to your party? You can't do that. We've been friends with Jeremy forever. Suzanne shook her head. Jeremy's your best friend, Katie, not mine, she insisted. I only hang out with him when you're around. Katie couldn't argue with that. It was true. Jeremy Fox and Suzanne were both Katie's best friends. The two of them got along okay when they were with Katie, but Jeremy and Suzanne didn't always like each other. What kind of party is it? Katie asked. A sleepover, Suzanne told her excitedly. I'm going to rent some movies. We'll do each other's hair and play games. My mom even said we can put on makeup if we wash it off before we go to sleep. Suzanne flashed Katie a secret smile. Of course, we're not going to sleep at all. Who sleeps at a sleepover? Katie shrugged. She didn't know how to answer that. She'd never been to a sleepover party before. So, will you come? Suzanne asked her. Katie nodded. Sure, sounds like fun.
Hey, you guys, what's up?
Jeremy asked as he walked over to where Suzanne and Katie were standing. Katie quickly stuffed her invitation into her backpack. Nothing, Katie murmured. She suddenly felt a little guilty about Suzanne's all-girl party, even though she wasn't the one who was throwing it. I gotta go, Suzanne said quickly. I need to talk to Mandy and Miriam about something important. She winked at Katie. Katie looked away. Jeremy laughed as Suzanne walked off.
Suzanne's so funny, he said.
Why? Katie asked.
She's always got something important to tell someone, he said. Doesn't she ever have nothing to say?
Katie giggled. Not Suzanne. Even if she did, she'd make a big deal about how she had nothing to say. Jeremy nodded. Then he changed the subject.
My parents are taking me to the Magic Lamp amusement park on Saturday night. We're going to check out that new lightning bolt roller coaster. They said I could bring a friend. Want to come?
Katie's eyes flashed. The lightning bolt was supposed to be an amazing roller coaster. The TV commercials said it has three loops and goes really fast. Wow, the lightning bolt would be a great one to add to my list, she exclaimed. Katie was trying to go on at least 50 roller coasters before she became a grown-up. So far, she'd been on 7 different ones.
That's what I thought, Jeremy told her.
I would love to go, Katie began. Then she remembered Suzanne's party. Except I can't go Saturday night, she finished sadly.
How come? Jeremy asked her.
Well, Katie stammered nervously. I kind of promised to hang out with Suzanne on Saturday night, she said finally. That was the truth. Jeremy didn't have to know about the all-girl party. Jeremy thought about that for a minute.
I guess I can bring 2 friends.
Katie gulped. She really didn't want to have to tell Jeremy about Suzanne's party. It would only hurt his feelings. Suzanne doesn't like roller coasters much, Katie said quickly.
Well, that's okay. Neither does my mom. They could go on the bumper cars while we're on the lightning bolt.
Katie sighed. Well, see,
Suzanne and I sort of have plans with some of the other girls in the class on Saturday night, and...
What kind of plans? Jeremy interrupted her.
It's nothing you'd want to do, Katie insisted.
What are you doing? Jeremy asked again.
Well, Suzanne's having this all-girl party, Katie blurted out finally. Jeremy pushed his glasses up on his nose and stared at Katie. He looked angry.
How come she's only inviting girls? He asked. That's not nice.
It's a sleepover party, Katie explained. We're going to put on makeup and do our hair and stuff. You wouldn't want to do that.
It's still not fair.
But Jeremy, it's a sleepover, Katie insisted again. Boys can't come. Jeremy didn't want to hear it.
Suzanne is being a total snob. She should have a party everyone can come to.
He stormed away angrily.
Where are you going? Katie called after him. I'm going to talk to George and Manny, Jeremy told her. Wait until they hear about this. They're going to be mad.
Katie played nervously with a lock of her red hair as she watched Jeremy walk away. She had a feeling this was not going to be a good day in Class 3A. Chapter 2. By lunchtime, Jeremy had told all the boys in Class 3A about Suzanne's sleepover party. Katie could tell they were mad because they were all sitting together at half of the lunch table. They were also giving the girls really dirty looks. The girls were sitting at the other end of the table. They were giving the boys dirty looks right back. By the time Katie reached the lunch table, the only seat left was next to George Brennan and Zoe Cantor, right between the girls and the boys. She put her tray down and slid onto her chair. George jumped up and moved his chair away from Katie. He picked up his hand and made believe he was holding some sort of spray can.
We want all girls to go away. Blast them hard with cootie spray.
He pretended to spritz Katie all over with invisible spray. He said, imitating a spray can. Katie jumped up with surprise. George, what are you doing? George shrugged.
I'm sorry, Katie Kazoo, but you're a girl. All girls have cooties. I'm just making sure I don't get them from you.
What are you talking about? She asked George. George moved his chair even farther from Katie.
Ew, get this girl away from me, he shouted.
All the boys laughed. That made Katie upset. George was her friend. He was the one who had given her the nickname Katie Kazoo. They told jokes together and played after school. Katie was the very first kid to become George's friend when he was the new kid at school. Now he wouldn't even sit next to her.
Come on, George, cut it out, Katie insisted.
George didn't answer. Instead, he took a huge bite of his bologna sandwich and turned toward his buddy, Kevin Camilleri.
Achoo!
George let out a really fake sneeze. Pieces of chewed up bologna, cheese, and bread sprayed out of his mouth and all over the table. Kevin chuckled.
Good one, George.
Ew, yuck!
Miriam Chan shouted. She was sitting across from Katie. That gave her a clear view of George's flying food.
Boys are really gross, Miriam's best friend Mandy Banks said. I don't know how you can be friends with any of them, Katie.
Katie sighed. She hated it when there were fights between the boys and the girls. Just a few weeks ago, Suzanne and Jeremy had had a fight about who would get to take Speedy, the class hamster, home for the weekend. The whole class had gotten involved in that war. The boys had sided with Jeremy, and the girls had sided with Suzanne. Katie had been stuck in the middle, right between her two best friends. Katie sighed. I wish this didn't always... Katie was about to wish that this didn't always have to happen to her, but she stopped herself. She'd learned the hard way to be really careful about what she wished for. It had all started one rotten day.
Katie had ruined her favorite jeans, lost the football game for her team, and belched really loudly in front of the whole class. That day, Katie had wished that she could be anyone but herself. Right after that, the magic wind came. The magic wind was big and horrible, like a tornado, but it only stormed around Katie. Nobody else could see it or feel it.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.